As we prepare to enter into communion and to a time of remembrance, I would ask that we take a few moments of silent confession, meditation, a few moments of remembering things in the past, both good and bad. And during the process of this communion, you can let go of the bad and move forward to the good. And then join me in the general confession that you'll find printed in the bulletin. Would you join with me, please? Infinite God of all peoples and all places, you created the earth with its mountains and valleys, oceans and plains, with no boundaries. Yet we have parceled out your good earth and built great monuments to protect our separate parcels. Forgive us and bring your spirit of unity into all peoples, that the world may live in harmony and war shall be no more. Through Jesus, the power of peace, we seek your forgiveness and guidance. Amen. If you have expressed a deep desire to yourself and to God to have a better tomorrow than you did yesterday, to move forward on your journey, free from those horrible things of the past and looking forward with hope to the light of the future, know that God's Spirit stands with you and will enter into that journey with you, holding your hand and guiding you as you walk along. Know that you are forgiven and your sins are removed from you as far as the east is from the west. Know this in your heart, know it in your spirit. Know it in the name of the God that created us, the Christ that redeems us, and the Holy Spirit which sustains us. Amen. So on the night that Jesus sat in an upper room celebrating a Passover meal, and with him were some of those people that he said, come, follow me. And they had. And as they sat celebrating that Passover meal, Jesus picked up bread from the table. He lifted it up to heaven and he gave thanks to God for it and he blessed it. And then he broke it. And he gave it to them, to those people that had answered the call. And he said, as he handed them the bread, he said, take and eat. This is my body, which will be given for you and for many. Toward the end of that Passover meal, Jesus picked up the cup that was on the table. And in a like manner, he lifted it up to heaven and he gave thanks to God for it and he blessed it. And then he handed them the cup. And he said, take each of you and drink from this cup, for this is the cup of my blood, which will be shed for you and for all people as a sign of the new and everlasting covenant for the forgiveness of sins. And then he added one more thing. He said, when you do this, listen carefully. When you do this, when you share bread and the cup, remember me. He didn't say, when you share the little white wafer at church, When you share, remember me. Join me in prayer, please. God, we pray that you send your Holy Spirit to bless and consecrate these elements, bread of the field and fruit of the vine, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord and Savior as we each one may perceive it to be. May this food from your table nourish our spirits in such a way that we will be brave enough to step out of our comfort zones, that we will be brave enough to answer the call when we hear your words, follow me, that we will say, yes, Lord, here I am. Show me the way. It's in the name of your Son, Jesus, we pray. Amen. Our Christian faith has a mystery. Would you recite that with me now?
Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again. The sacrifice has been made. I challenge you to stop making it and to move forward in liberty, in freedom. God created us all to journey forward.